My name is Pritam Sarkar, and today I'll talk about my sixth experiment of digital signal processing lab. In this lab, we need to design a low pass filter using pole zero location method for the analysis of signal. Now, first we'll look at the theory of pole zero placement method. Pole zero placement method is an important tool which helps us to relate with the frequency domain and the Z domain transformation. So first we will see the expression of Z transform the transfer function of Z transform. We will replace Z by e to the power Z omega, and thus we can easily get the Fourier transform of the signal. And in the pole zero, we will add poles and zeros to in the Z plane to create a filter which will filter out all the required components. Now first we will look at designing a low pass FIR filter using pole zero placement method. In this first question, we will look at removing a baseline noise by designing a low pass FIR filter. Our cutoff frequency is 0.4 Hz and our sampling frequency is 80 Hz. First, we will take the sample, and we are creating a radius. The point at which we will put our pole is at a distance of R, and R is defined as 1 minus 2 pi cutoff frequency by the sampling frequency. And thus we will get the value of R, and the value of gain is nothing but the average of 1 and R. That way we can design a low pass filter with cutoff of R, and we can change it back to our FIR filter form, and thus we can write the following expression, which is given here as an FIR filter. And thus we will run our code. We have given our sample and the SAMP array, and thus we will see our output. As we can see, the above plot is of a PVC signal which are baseline shift, and the below blue colored signal is of a filtered PVC signal without a baseline shift. This is the plot that we will getting that we are getting from code 1. The second code, we need to add three noise frequencies, and then we need to remove it using the same procedure by passing it through a low pass FIR filter, and we are using the same filter. In this case, we are keeping the noise amplitude same as 1 1 1, and then similarly we are adding the noise, and then we will find the SNR value, mean square error value, and the root square error value. And the expressions are given here. And now in the second plot, we will see what plots we are getting. This is the plot for B, and as you can see, this is the PPC signal with added baseline noise of 0.1, 0.2, and 0.25 Hz, and the below signal is the filtered PPC signal with a filtered baseline shift. And in this case, we can see that we are getting the MSE, RMSE, and SNR value, and we got a very good value of MSE as 0.2, RMSE as 0.5, and SNR value of 6.17 dB. That's all for this lab. Thank you for listening.